Your priests, O Lord, shall be clothed with justice. Your holy ones shall ring out their joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who made Saint Peter Claver a slave of slaves and strengthened him with wonderful clarity and patience as he came to their help, grant through his intercession that, seeking the things of Jesus Christ, we may love our neighbor in deeds and in truth, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The word of the Lord came to me thus: Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I dedicated you. A prophet to the nations, I appointed you. Ah, Lord God, I said, I know not how to speak. I am too young. But the Lord answered me, Say not, I am too young. To whomever I send you, you shall go. Whatever I command you, you shall speak. Have no fear before them, because I am with you to deliver you, says the Lord. Then the Lord extended his hand and touched my mouth, saying, See, I place my words in your mouth. The word of the Lord. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will.
I have waited for the Lord, and he stooped toward me and heard my cry, and he put a new song into my mouth, a hymn to our God. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. Sacrifice or offering you wished not, but ears open to obedience you gave me. Burnt offerings or sin offerings you sought not. Then said I, Behold, I come. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. In the written scroll it is prescribed for me to do your will, O my God, is my delight, and your law is within my heart. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. I announced your justice in the vast assembly. I did not restrain my lips, as you, O Lord, know. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, Come, you who are blessed by my Father. Inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me. Naked, and you clothed me. Ill, and you cared for me. In prison, and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him and say, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you? And the king will say to them in reply, Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of the least brothers of mine, you did for me. The Gospel of the Lord. So oftentimes when we read this gospel, you know, we see this whole story, whatever you did for the least of your brothers, you did for me, and the separation of the sheep and the goats. And oftentimes the aspect of what we tend to focus on is the sort of, when you denied to help out your, brother and sister here on earth and everything, you did that to Christ. You didn't, you failed to do that. Okay, you know what happens to them, which, fair enough. I mean, it's important. It's kind of a key foundational thing to have internalized if we're going to navigate this life as a Christian. There's a certain aspect of it that I want to emphasize a bit more with today's homily, which is that this business of seeing that person that we visit in prison, that we feed, that we clothe, give something to drink, whatever the case may be, seeing that person as Christ, serving Christ, that tells us something about the disposition with which we need to encounter those people and help people. And it just reminds me of years ago when I was a residency brother in San Francisco at our parish, St. Dominic's. I remember one of the things I did was spending time with those who did homelessness outreach. And so I started going to some of these different kind of social justice type meetings in the city. And I remember going to this one in particular, very, really sort of, kind of self-identified liberal type, San Francisco people. And I remember this one woman who was really involved in that sort of activism got up and she was speaking. And she was saying, a lot of people, we here in San Francisco, we love to think of ourselves as so liberal and so just, zeroed in on the good of the downtrodden and everything. And she said, I really think it's largely just a veneer. It's something we like to tell ourselves. But the fact is, she said, it's not something that really people really put into practice that much. It's just people kind of do it in very superficial ways, and they like to see themselves in this kind of lofty way. But she said, in terms of people's real concern for those who are really in a tough time, in a tough way, she didn't really see that happening in a very substantive way with a lot of these very enlightened San Francisco liberals. And she said, a key thing, change that she wanted to see in her fellow San Franciscans was in the disposition with which they looked at the poor. And so she said, when you're helping a poor person in this city, don't view them as in a kind of a paternalistic way, a patronizing way. Here you go, I'm here to help you, She said, rather view that person as a person whose cause you share. Like you are in there, you are with them in their cause, basically. Don't have the paternalistic way. And I thought, Christianity really has the answer to that in a certain sense, because when we encounter those we visit in prison, those who are hungry that we feed, those who are thirsty we give drink, and all of the rest, we're supposed to remember that we are seeing Christ. And we're certainly not going to be treating Christ in a paternalistic way. We are going to see that person who is Christ in a certain sense as someone whose cause we are in, the cause of Christ. And so it's just a really important thing to have the right kind of mentality when we engage in these various gospel commands that we receive from Jesus. And I remember So before COVID, in the young adult group, we got this activity going where we would go and hand out sandwiches to people just who were homeless, who needed something to eat out on the streets. COVID happened, and then the whole thing, you know, got shut down, and we're trying to kind of get it started up again. But there's this guy who was in charge of an organization that he started here in Anchorage, where they actually go and walk the streets and give people food or give them other things they might need as a way of kind of just setting up conversations about the faith. So they try to attend to people's spiritual needs and their material needs. And so I was just, what he was doing required a bit more commitment than I thought that our young adults, some of our young adults were ready to do. But I wanted to kind of do our own version of it. And so I said, do you have any pointers in terms of what you do? And he said, well, one of the things that I would encourage you in is you're going to go out and give out sandwiches. Make sure you make a sandwich that you would actually want to eat. Because he said a lot of people just kind of throw something together and say, oh, the poor, they're probably happy with this. You know, they're hungry otherwise. So they just kind of throw it out there and everything. He says, what I really like to do is, put in some lettuce, you know, slice up some tomato, and really put a lot of meat in, make a really good sandwich that I would actually like to eat myself. And that goes a long way in treating that person as someone with whom you share a cause, the cause of Christ. And so, you know, one of our projects we have going at the parish right now, it's kind of a collaboration with the Knights of Columbus, which is are those food bins that we have out in the vestibule. And so we're going to take those to St. Francis Shelter. And you'll notice that, you know, there's a list of the kinds of things that they need, and St. Francis Shelter has provided that. Though they are certainly, those are certainly people who understand being in the, you know, united in cause with those who really need extra help. And so as we participate in that project and we go to the store and we bring things in and all that, let's try to remember not just to do that, not just to run to the store, buy that stuff and dump it in those bins, but really do so with the right mentality, not in a paternalistic sort of way or in a way of, okay, well, I did my job, now I don't have to feel guilty anymore. No. Let's really do that with the mentality of, these are people whose cause I am united in, which is the cause of Christ. Heavenly Father, trusting in your divine providence, we now bring forward our petitions. For all of us as Christians, that we never fail to see Christ in every person we encounter, we pray to the Lord. For the Spirit's guidance of Archbishop Andrew Belisario as his installation approaches, we pray to the Lord. And for all of us as Catholic voters, that we educate ourselves about how to be Catholic voters and really apply that to how we vote, we pray to the Lord. For our schools, our Catholic schools, Lumen Christi and Holy Rosary Academy, that things continue to go smoothly so that they can stay open, we pray to the Lord. And for the repose of the soul of Tetsu Nishitomi, for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord. Lord, we entrust these prayers to your loving care through Christ our Lord.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings placed on your altar in commemoration of blessed Peter Claver, so that as you brought him glory, you may, through these sacred mysteries, grant to us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Peter Claver you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Peter Claver and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Andrew, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Tetsu, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So I'm going to distribute communion to you now, and since I'm the only priest here to distribute communion, I would like to distribute to those who want to receive in the hand first, and then I'll distribute to those who want to receive on the tongue. Just keep in mind that when you come up to receive, you don't have to leave after that. You can go back to your pew because Mass won't be over yet. So for those who would like to receive in the hand, please form a line right now, minding your social distancing. And then those who want to receive on the tongue can come up right after that.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
This is the steward, faithful and prudent, whom the Lord set over his household to give them their allowance of food at the proper time. Let us pray. May partaking at the heavenly table, Almighty God, confirm and increase strength from on high in all who celebrate the feast day of Blessed Peter Claver, that we may preserve in integrity the gift of faith and walk in the path of salvation you trace for us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.